Imagine a government bypassing human rights laws to control borders. Shocking, isn't it? That's exactly what the UK government did with its controversial deportation plan to Rwanda. In a bold move that sparked controversy globally, the UK government published an emergency bill, the so-called Safety of Rwanda Bill. This legislation was designed to overcome legal challenges and deem Rwanda a safe country for deportations. The bill bypassed certain human rights laws and court injunctions, leading to concerns about potential human rights abuses. The resignation of the immigration minister following the announcement of the bill highlighted the discord within the government itself. Yet, despite the internal and external opposition, the Prime Minister stood firm, supporting the bill as a means to control borders and discourage illegal migration. Critics of the scheme raised their voices, pointing to the potential for human rights abuses. The courts didn't stay silent either, ruling the deportation scheme unlawful under human rights laws. The bill's implications for human rights and the rule of law raised eyebrows and sparked debates in households, coffee shops, and the halls of power alike. Yet the UK government remained undeterred. For them, the success of the Rwanda plan wasn't just about border control or deterring illegal migration. It was also about political survival. The unfolding of this plan became a crucial aspect of the Conservative Party's immigration policy and their electoral prospects. With courts ruling the scheme unlawful under human rights laws, the unfolding of this plan becomes a crucial aspect of the Conservative Party's immigration policy and their electoral prospects. The UK government's plan to send asylum seekers to Rwanda was deemed lawful, but not without criticism. In a world where the law often dances a delicate ballet with morality, the UK's controversial deportation plan is no exception. The High Court of the United Kingdom validated the plan's legality, marking a significant milestone for the ruling Conservative Party. This ruling, however, does not equate to a unanimous approval. The court's decision was met with a chorus of criticism, particularly from human rights groups who questioned the ethical implications of the plan. These organizations argue that the scheme is inhumane, especially considering Rwanda's less than stellar human rights record. They assert that sending asylum seekers to a country with such a reputation is akin to turning a blind eye to potential abuses, and they're not alone in their concerns. The European Court of Human Rights, a body known for its dedication to the preservation of human rights, has also raised eyebrows at the UK's deportation plan. But it's not all a one-sided argument. The UK government has its defense. They argue that this plan is a necessary deterrent for people trafficking gangs, facilitating dangerous channel crossings. It's a bold stance, suggesting that the ends justify the means, that the potential protection of countless lives outweighs the potential human rights concerns. But is this a valid argument, or is it a thin veneer covering a more complex issue? This plan doesn't just involve the UK and Rwanda, it involves real people, individuals fleeing hardship and seeking refuge. Each person's case is unique and deserves individual consideration, not a one-size-fits-all solution. The High Court's ruling may have deemed the plan lawful, but it also highlighted the need for individual consideration in deportation cases. It's a subtle caveat, but a significant one. It suggests that the legality of the plan doesn't absolve the UK of its duty to consider the human element in its asylum policies. Despite the court's decision, the question remains: is the UK's deportation plan humane? The saga continues as the controversial law to send asylum seekers to Rwanda passes, despite months of wrangling. This bill, which has sparked widespread debate and opposition, navigated the stormy waters of the House of Lords. It was here that the call for additional safeguards echoed in the historic halls. These were not just pleas for amendments, but a cry for humanity and justice. Yet despite the uproar, the bill passed without changes, a testament to the unyielding stance of the Conservative government. As we delve deeper into the unfolding drama, the potential human rights implications of this law cannot be ignored. Are we turning a blind eye to the plight of these asylum seekers? Are we sending them back to a country with a questionable human rights record? These questions remain unanswered, casting a long shadow over the legality and morality of this deportation scheme. But human rights are not the only issue at stake. Let's not forget the high cost of deportation. The financial burden that this law imposes is significant. It's not just about chartering flights to Rwanda, but also about maintaining the facilities, the administrative procedures, and the legal battles that may follow. The cost, both human and financial, is steep, yet the government stands by its decision. They believe that this law will deter illegal migration and control the borders. But one can't help but wonder, at what cost? Is it worth sacrificing our principles, our values, and our humanity for the sake of border control? The law has passed, but at what cost to human rights and the country's financial resources? The first deportation flights are expected soon, but the controversy is far from over. As we look to the horizon, the United Kingdom's controversial asylum seeker deportation plan is about to take flight. The first of these contentious journeys to Rwanda are set to commence in the near future. But even as the engines are warming up, the storm of opposition is far from abating. This turbulence is not only from within the country. International figures, including United Nations rights experts, have expressed their concerns about the potential human rights implications of this legislation. These voices of disapproval echo the sentiments of many within the UK, who view the plan as a risky gamble with the lives and futures of vulnerable individuals. As the plane prepares for takeoff, the UK government is also bracing for potential legal challenges, both domestically and internationally. The Supreme Court previously deemed the scheme illegal, and the lingering question remains: will this ruling stand as a precedent for future judgments? But amidst the legal wrangling and human rights concerns, there is a different narrative being spun within the walls of the Conservative government. To them, this legislation isn't just about border control or deterring illegal migration. It's seen as a potential boost for their electoral prospects. The hope is that demonstrating a firm hand on immigration matters will resonate with a portion of the voting populace who are concerned about these issues. However, this political gamble is not without risks. The potential backlash from those opposing the plan, coupled with the legal hurdles and human rights criticisms, could serve to undermine their electoral strategy. The stage is set and the actors are in place. The UK is about to embark on a bold and controversial experiment in immigration policy. The world watches with bated breath as the first deportation flights loom and the UK tests the boundaries of its immigration policies. The UK's deportation plan to Rwanda has sparked a global debate on immigration control and human rights. As we wrap up our in-depth look at this contentious issue, let's reflect on the key points discussed. This controversial plan, which has led to the resignation of the immigration minister and faced staunch opposition, has certainly caused ripples far beyond the borders of the UK. It's more than just a policy change. It's a symbol of a much larger global dialogue on how we handle migration and uphold human rights. The proposed legislation, dubbed the Safety of Rwanda Bill, attempts to bypass certain human rights laws and court injunctions. This bold move has been met with criticism and concern, as it seems to undermine the very essence of human rights protections. Even the Supreme Court ruled the scheme illegal, highlighting the serious legal hurdles it faces. The implications of this plan stretch far beyond the realm of legalities. It has potential human rights implications that many find deeply troubling. The high cost of deportation, coupled with concerns about Rwanda's human rights record, has added fuel to the fire. Critics argue that the policy is inhumane, and the opposition from UN rights experts underscores these concerns. Despite these challenges, the Conservative government is pushing forward, hoping the legislation will boost its electoral prospects. Yet, this political maneuvering doesn't alleviate the fears of potential human rights abuses or the ethical questions raised about deporting asylum seekers to a country with a questionable human rights record. In the end, this plan is more than just a story about the UK's immigration policy. It's a reflection of the global struggle to find a balance between national security, immigration control, and the preservation of human rights. It's a stark reminder that how we treat the most vulnerable among us speaks volumes about our values as a society. As we continue to grapple with global migration crises, the UK's deportation plan serves as a stark reminder that the balance between immigration control and human rights is a delicate one. For more videos, like, share, subscribe, and follow Road Tory.